Eruptive activity continues to diminish at Kilauea Volcano, and that's prompted the Hawaiian Volcano Observatory to lower the alert level from warning to watch. But officials say this does not mean the hazards posed by crater collapse and lava flows are over. So residents should stay informed and heed all warnings. Meanwhile, the lull in seismic activity is giving park rangers a chance to assess the damage at the state's biggest park. Saturday marks the 100th day since Hawaii Volcanoes National Park closed to the public. For only the second time, park rangers gave us access to see the damage up close. Bridget Namada follows up.
Park rangers took us on a tour through Hawaii Volcanoes National Park. On average, about 5,000 to 6,000 visitors come to this park daily. But if any of those visitors came back today, they'd be shocked. Much of the beloved landmarks are broken or unrecognizable. It's been about 100 days since the park first closed, and since then, the park continues to change drastically.
This is what Halemaumau Crater looks like now. The lava lake is drained. The crater has quadrupled in size.
It's gone from a couple hundred feet deep to 1,500 feet deep in places now. So the changes are staggering that we've seen here at the crater. There's no active lava lake anymore. It is like Pele left her home at the summit, went out to the Lower East Rift, and we really fell apart, literally and figuratively, without her.
Beyond the crater, many roads have formed deep cracks in the asphalt, cutting off car and foot access to certain parts of the park. Park ranger Jessica Farrakane says the latest eruption caused an unprecedented amount of earthquakes. From June till early August, officials counted 18,000 per month.
Hawaii Volcanoes National Park has taken a real beating from all of this volcanic and seismic activity. Our trails are full of sinkholes. There's parts that have crumbled into the crater. Crater Rim Drive, the back part of it, fell into Halemaumau Crater several weeks ago. We have broken water lines. Our buildings and other infrastructure are damaged.
Farrakane says this gaping hole started out as a puka the size of a dinner plate only 2 weeks ago. This is the visitor center at the park. Once a bustling, busy area, it's now covered in ash and overgrown grass. Thankfully, park rangers say, seismic activity has slowed to a lull, giving officials time to assess the full extent of damage to the park. Will Hawaii Volcanoes National Park ever fully reopen? That's the hope, and Farrakane says a team of experts will work on it. But for now, the park is closed indefinitely. Reporting from the Big Island, Bridget Namata, KHON 2 News.